Hey guys, and welcome. My name is NG Paradox, and we're going to be playing another short series. Now, I wanted to play in the Feast of Crows scenario, but obviously that one has spoilers. So I decided to do this one as well, to allow people who don't want spoilers to be able to watch another new series as well. So we are playing in Robert's Rebellion. We're going to be playing as Robert Baratheon. I'm surprised I have never actually done this before. Which kind of surprises me. You'd think by now this had been one I would have played. I know it's quite popular for a lot of people. So we're playing as Robert Baratheon in Robert's Rebellion. I'm just going to jump straight in. So this will be a short series, so we're just going to be taking the throne, maybe play for a little bit longer to see the aftermath, and that will be it for this series. It's not going to be a long series. I'm going to wait until the game's updated before we do any new ones, any new long series. Okay. So I know a lot of people, they like to debate about Robert Baratheon. A lot of people hate him. They think he's a horrible man, a womanizer, a drinker. He wasn't really a good man. And was a bad king and a bad father, bad husband. Basically just, yeah, not a good man. But there are some people who see him as a tragic character. You know, the loss of Lyanna made maybe his drinking and womanizing even worse. And because he was with women he didn't love and everything like that, he kind of fell into depression. He kind of seemed like a depressed man. A lot of people have different views. I would love to hear your guys' comments. Tell me in the comment section. What do you think about Robert Baratheon? Is he a guy you like? Is he a guy you hate? I would love to see your points of view. I usually see him as a tragic fellow, but that's me. My beloved Lyanna has been kidnapped by Prince Rhaegar. After protesting this cruel act to King Aerys, Rickard Stark has been cruelly burned alive, whilst his son Brandon looked on. Now Eddard Stark and I, with our allies, stand against the Mad King's tyranny. I will crush the Targaryens with my hammer. Yes, so we are at war. So the Mad King has basically gone crazy and burned the Starks alive, then calling for mine and Eddard's heads from Jon Arryn. But Jon Arryn stood against the Mad King and said he would not take our heads, and we've rose up in rebellion. I think the Tullys join us. Yep, the Tullys are with us, obviously. He's married his two daughters to Jon Arryn and Eddard Stark. So this would be an interesting war. I think it's quite even. You know, he has, obviously, Dorn. He has the Reach and, obviously, the Crownlands and a few other places. But we have four Paramountcies. There's four Paramountcies versus three. But he does have the Reach. And the Reach is probably the strongest one. So I think it's slightly even. We're going to see if we can try and make it uneven. Lots of my bannermen are on the side of the king. Let's go for an ambition. There's Lyanna, my true love. She's trapped by Prince Rhaegar. How could he? He has a wife. It all makes sense now. That's why he declared a queen and lover beauty at Harrenhal, at the tourney of Harrenhal. He's always wanted her, but she's mine. And I'll get her back. I'll fight till the end for her. And obviously for my safety, because otherwise I'll be killed. Lord Stannis we have, obviously, Renly. Maybe we should look for an ally for Stannis. Maybe get him married to someone. Do you know what? Cersei. Interesting. Okay, that changes my plans, actually. I was trying to think what I was going to do for how I was going to attack. Because obviously at the moment in the Stormlands, we're kind of separate, you know? We got Dorne here, the Reach here, and the Crownlands here. We can't really escape. We need these guys to come and relieve us and help us by attacking the Crownlands so we can escape with our men. But if we can get Tywin to join us, wow, why did they not do this in the first place? This seems like an obvious thing to do. I could not imagine this marriage, though. Could you imagine this marriage? This would be the worst marriage ever. This would be worse than me and Cersei. I'm going to do it. One thing, it would be great tactically, because obviously, you know, Robert's not going to marry Cersei. He wants Lyanna. She's mine. We'll get her back. But these two would be hilarious. I actually would love... I really wish that happened now. That would just be so great to watch. That would be amazing. So let's get them two married then. Why am I clicking that? I'm an idiot. Let's click. I'm going to get them married. Hopefully that means we can then call them into war, which would be great. If he joined us, I don't see how we could lose. This would actually maybe be far easier than I thought it would be. But I guess win the war, I guess is probably what we want to do. Yeah, win the war. Get Lyanna back. Unmarried heir. Open council. Okay, let's look at our council. We need a master of laws. I guess, Andrin, you'll be it. Though, we'll keep Tarth happy. We'll make him it, because he's the High Lord. Improve relations. Go improve relations then with Tywin. It's probably a good idea. Master Arms, you should probably lead troops. Let's get all our men ready. We've about 20,000 troops. We don't have that many men, really. And they're quite spread out. We're going to need to be careful here. So bring all our men to Dragonstone. We should probably take, actually, Griffin's Roost. So you guys jump to here, and you'll get together and meet us at Griffin's Roost. We'll take the Conningtons home. Let's get our main commanders then. Robert Baratheon, 29 Marshal. That is ridiculous. 29 Marshals. So I'm going to play Robert Baratheon the way I think he's like. Obviously, Richard Horp. He's pretty good. Skilled fighter. 19 years old. Then we can go with, I guess, Stannis. He's a flanker as well, so that's good. Leads from the rear. Okay, defense, moral damage. I'm going to go with him. We obviously have Garen. Courtney Penrose. I don't know why I've always liked Courtney Penrose. I think it's just his actions during the clash of the War of the Five Kings. I've just always liked him after that. We're going to go with Stannis, my brother. There we go. That's a good army. I'll wait for the morale to go up. And let's begin. Wait, in command happened to us. There we go. There's John Connington's army. We need to capture them before they get away. The Reacher's armies. We're going to need to be careful. I don't want to lose too many men. Hopefully we can get this marriage sorted. And hopefully the Vale and the Riverlands can come to our defense and relieve me so I can escape. Because we don't want to be trapped in here when the Dornish come and the Reach. We want to try and get out of here before the Reach get here. That's kind of my plan right now. Okay, he's got 3,000 men there. Looks like he's going to escape. If John Condon is going to escape, I just don't have the morale right now. He accepts it. Perfect. Welcome, Cersei. It's lovely to have you here. I hope you love your new husband, Stannis. He's a great guy. You'll love him. Oh my god, that's scary. Come on, Tywin. You know you want to help us. Your son will be the heir to the Iron Throne. I mean, your husband will be the heir to the Iron Throne. You can kill me. Obviously, Robert doesn't know he'd probably do that at this point. I don't think at this point people knew how cunning Tywin was. I think people knew he was a good man. Very tactical, very good politician. Because he's been a Hand of the King for a long time. But a very capable Hand of the King, apparently. Everyone's concerned. People respect wealth, yes. We don't need money. Then again, it is Tywin. He can give us a lot of money. No, we want the prestige. Host a wedding feast. We're not going to bother. We're at war right now. I don't think that's that important. Need to get all our men together. Yes, we have Tywin joining. Well, I think that will be the end of the war. I can't see him winning. With Tywin also joining us. Wow, that's so easy. Maybe this will be a quicker series than I thought. The Faith Militant has been restored. That's not good. Yeah, okay, maybe we'll play a little bit longer then and see the aftermath of the war. What happens after if we do win. I can't see us losing at the moment, but you never know what happened. This is the Game of Thrones. Anything can happen. Okay, with this army up here, Roland is leading. That's a good leader. We're going to send you... Should I send him just here to attack them? They do have low morale, so we're going to send him here. But if he joins in, they're going to be in trouble. You go there. How many people defend this? Okay, we're going to have these guys take this. When do you get here? 22nd of November. 11th. That can take a long time to get here. Okay, we're just going to send us straight off to attack these guys. So we're going to go and try and relieve these guys. You guys are going to try and take Griffin's Roost. We got some really good leaders at the moment in the Stormlands. You're going to wait for them, though, because they could then come and attack. Actually, they won't come and attack you because we're coming to help. So there we go. They'll go there. Okay, perfect. Once they get there on the 22nd, we'll then do something. Okay, hopefully this goes well. Damn you, traitor John Connington. How dare you betray me? John Connington, though, best friends with Rhaegar Targaryen. How could he... Yep, I knew it. They're probably going to go and try and relieve these guys. We're going to go and try and help. Hopefully. Hopefully we'll get there in time. Oh, the Tyrells have sent a party by ship. That is a surprise, actually. You also come and help. The men from Tarth, I guess. Okay, they'll start winning that. Oh, Jesus Christ. Okay. We're in trouble. 11,000 men here. I shouldn't have jumped into that. The army of Prince Rhaegar. Ooh. We want to go meet him, yes. Let's get everyone ready. Okay, we're going to go meet them. So there's going to be two battles happening here. Forget Griffin's Roost. No one cares. Same with you. Okay, you're going there. 7th of December. Okay, so we've got two battles going on. They're going down to here. We need everyone to go. We need support. Okay, you're going to go there, so you go here. Jesus. Okay, we're going to win that battle. So we captured in battle Catherine, one of my vassals. There we go. That's a good then. We actually caught Thornton, so that's good. We've actually captured one of the traitors. That's the one I wanted. You're going to get here on the 29th. Ooh, can we escape? No, 7th of January. Jesus, takes a long time to get there. 2nd of January. So, ooh, we can actually get these guys away. So we can get these guys away, though I don't know what's going to be down here. It's probably not good. Look at our men. We still have 3,000 men available. I don't know why they weren't called upon. I guess they weren't available at the time or something. We haven't got enough money right now. How are our allies doing then? So the Westlands are just mustering their men. The Paynes and Horn Vale are not helping them, it looks like. Yeah. The Riverlands is united. They're sending 13,000 men to attack. We have the Graftons over here. Yep, the Graftons have risen up to support the throne. But other than that, it looks like they're just getting their men together. They've got 2,000 men heading down. Not really enough. Where are all your soldiers? 8,000. John, come on. You can raise more than that. And here comes Eddard Stark. Good old Ed. Good old Ed. Hopefully they get down here soon enough. You know, right now we're okay, but as soon as the Reach and Dawn get here, we're going to be in trouble. And the last thing we want is for us to be captured, because obviously I'm the war leader. So that'd be the worst thing. So I've managed to escape. They're still going to Thornton. How about we head here just for safety, just in case they keep trying to get here. They could probably also catch you if you just go there. 25th of December. Okay, how about you go, yeah. You go there. Keep an eye over here. We're going to take out this army quite easily, it looks like. More men down here. Fighting across the field, you see an enemy soldier cut off from the others. While you can't tell who, it's clear that they must be a highborn noble. Ooh, could be Grandison. Charge! Of course. Oh. This is interesting. So Robert Baratheon. Okay, as you get closer, you realize the enemy soldier is Lord John of Griffin's Roost. You traitor. So a lot of people actually think he's gay. As you can see here, it says homosexual. A lot of people think maybe he, shall we say, loved Rhaegar a bit too much. Maybe. It depends. There's no obvious clues, but yeah, that's what people think. I'm still undecided. It wouldn't surprise me, though. It sounds like it probably sounds like it probably is. But we're only a skilled fighter. That's a surprise. We're only a skilled fighter. Strong. He's a formidable... Ooh, this actually could be bad. I'm surprised we're just a skilled fighter. But of course, Robert will prepare to die. You and Lord John of Griffin's Roost slowly circle each other, tense and focused. You scan him for any sign of weakness, any opening in his defense that you could possibly exploit. One mistake is all it gets. I can just imagine John with his hammer. Robert with his hammer, John fending him off the Griffin. One mistake is all it gets. Okay, you see a weak spot, a vulnerability. It's not much, but it's all you need. Go on, Robert, take him down. You can't die at the beginning. We just started the war. Strike! Lord John of Griffin's Roost tries to fight back, but you force your way through, easily overpowering his pathetic defense. You strike through his heart with all your might. Ours is the fury! And he's gone. Lord John of Griffin's Roost crumples to the ground, lifeless. You wipe his blood from your weapon. The deed is done. He is dead. Valor Morghulis. I'm so sorry, John. It had to be done. There we go. Victory is mine. So we won that battle. That is pretty good. Who became the new lord? Ronald Conanton. Okay. Let's get all our men together. We only have about 11,000 here, 15,000. So we could take on this army, but I'm thinking we shouldn't. I don't think we should, because at any point these guys could bring more men. We can't see what they're doing. So at any point more men could just appear here. So I'd rather not. I'd rather go join the Riverlands. We need to escape. So that's going to be my plan. We'll wait for these guys to get there. You get there on the 19th. So one day. There we go. Oh, and we're still fighting them apparently. Okay. These guys are going to 25th. 16,000 men right now. We can see quite well here. Okay, we see there's no Reachmen here. What are these guys doing? Okay, they're going into the Reach. That's good. Tywin has quite a lot. Yeah, Tywin has a good amount of men. That's perfect. Fighting here against Dary. They should be fine. Okay, Jon is still not doing much. Ed still hasn't gotten anywhere. But so far, it's going well. I'm really happy we defeated Jon Connington. I was really worried we'd actually die. Because he's a good fighter. There was a good chance we could have died. It looks like he's going to attack me. Which again makes me concerned. Why would he attack me? We are in mountain terrain. So I feel like we could take them. But that worries me. Because I think, why? Why are they attacking me in this situation? How long will it take you to get there? 24th of January. 17th. Okay, how about you go to Grassfair? How about you be our lookout? You can kind of look around. We'll see. Now, the question is, can we even escape anyway? And do I want to? Do I want to fight in 28th? Let's have a look here. How long would it take? So the 20th. So we could escape. We can actually get out of here. The 19th. It might be best just to go there. Because then, I mean, do I want to fight him though? We only have 5,000 more men. If he can get 5,000 more men to join the battle, we'd be screwed. If we can just get to these, we've won. Yeah, I'm going to go. We're going to get out of here. We defeated Jon Connington. That's what we wanted. We're going to move out of here, join up with our allies, and crush them. We'll crush Ray. Oh, Jesus. Okay, there you go. That's why he wanted the fight. Oh, Jesus. Okay, we're screwed. We are in a bad place. Okay. Yeah, if I go down here, we're screwed. We're into the forest. Okay, let's get out of there. Okay, how long would it take you? 2nd of February. Yep, we can't go there then. 14th of January. Okay, we can go there. Wow, that's really quick. Okay, yeah, we're going to go back to Griffin's Roost. Okay. That's really bad, actually. Okay, you guys don't want to go forward. The Reach is up there. We need to get to our allies. We have two massive armies. We're not idiots. We need to get out of here. Okay, you stay at Summerhall for now. How about, actually, no, you go back. I don't want you to get involved with these guys. Okay. Okay, Storm's End. How many fleets do we have? 10 boats. Lovely. Well, that will be extremely helpful. 2nd of February. We've got some ships here. Hopefully we can make... We don't want to run down here. If we run down here, we're trapped. So we might as well just try and move on. Okay, looks like they're going to stop there. That's good. Good go and reach. 5,000. Yep, definitely a good idea to move. Okay, in the end it paid off. Sometimes it's risky. Sometimes when you try and outmaneuver them, it ends up being a risky choice. Oh, we just escape in time. Jesus. Okay, then it wouldn't have been too bad. But yeah, as you can see, look, the enemy's falling upon us now. Though the Tullys are coming. Oh no, they're going back to Stockworth. Come on, Tullys. We need your men. And here comes Tywin with 14,000, 11,000. Okay. Could be Tywin that ends up relieving us.